In this video, I will be demonstrating how to create an accessible modal dialog using the HTML5 dialog tag. It uses a polyfill for browsers that don't support it yet natively. For details on the polyfill and more information on how this demo was built, please check out the video's accompanying blog post on useragentman.com. The first browser we are going to demonstrate is Safari using VoiceOver, which is built into OS X. Right now, keyboard focuses on the link just before the button labeled Login to our website, which will open the modal when pressed. So, let's use the keyboard to navigate to the button.
Login to our website, button main 2 items.
And now we'll hit the Enter key.
Close this dialog button, web dialog, login 1 item. In order to continue, please log into the application.
You may have noticed that when the dialog opened, the Close button gained focus. Also, note that the screen reader said Close this dialog button. This tells the screen reader user that focus is on a button labeled Close this dialog. Incidentally, this label was coded as an alt attribute for the button's image tag. You'll also note that the screen reader reports it as a web dialog. That's because the button is inside an HTML dialog tag. VoiceOver would also announce this if the modal was coded as a div tag with its role attribute set to dialog. In fact, setting the role to dialog is what the polyfill does on all dialog tags, so screen readers can report the dialog properly to the user. Finally, you will notice the screen reader reads out the header and the description in the dialog. This happens because the dialog tag has its aria labeled by attribute set to the ID of the header, and its aria describe by attribute set to the ID of the description text. Now, let's find out what happens when we tab past the end of the dialog.
Username, edit text with autofill menu. To a password, secure edit text with auto cancel button. You are confirm button. You are close this dialog button.
You'll notice that when I hit the tab key after the confirm button, focus goes to the first element in the dialog. Focus never goes to any interactive element behind the modal. For browsers that support the dialog tag, this automatically happens because it is native browser behavior. However, for browsers that don't, the polyfill steps in and uses focus events to implement this. If focus goes outside the dialog, it loops back to the first element of the modal, if we are tabbing forward, of course. If we are tabbing backward, using a shift tab, then focus goes to the last element of the modal. And now, let's find out what happens when I close the modal.
Log into our website, button main 2 items.
You'll notice that focus is placed back to the button that opened it. Surprisingly, this is not default browser behavior, even though this is considered best practice in the wai-aria documentation. It is added by a bit of code in the polyfill. The code is executed for all browsers, including those with native support for the dialog tag. Now, let's look at Google Chrome using Android's built-in screen reader, TalkBack.
Progress bar.
I am using a Samsung tablet for this demonstration. But the behavior for this device is, more or less, the same on any Android device using this software. I'm going to start by navigating to the link just before the button that opens the modal. Since this device doesn't have a keyboard, TalkBack users must swipe left and right to navigate back and forth within the document.
Notes, heading, and list, 2 items. This example uses creating accessible HTML5 modal dialogs for desktop and mobile. Link. Double tap. Log in to our website. Button. Out of list. Double tap.
You'll also note that it looks like focus is not just going to the interactive elements of the page, like the tab key does on a keyboard-enabled device. Instead, TalkBack's so-called accessibility focus goes to all items on the page that can be read. This is default behavior for TalkBack, and iOS's VoiceOver screen reader has similar behavior. This can be changed, but I will leave that for a future video. Now, let's double tap to activate this button.
Close this dialog button. Double tap to activate.
Again, you will notice that focus goes to the close button. However, unlike VoiceOver, TalkBack didn't read the dialog's heading or the description. It also doesn't mention that you are now inside a web dialog. This is because different screen readers don't support all the ARIA attributes equally. This is the reason why it chose Close this dialog as the alt attribute for the close button image. It tells the user that they are inside a dialog, even if a particular screen reader doesn't support the dialog role. This is a good example that, just like at all aspects of web development, you should use progressive enhancement to make your code bulletproof. Now, let's try to swipe backwards past the close button at the beginning of the dialog.
An accessible modal dialog using the HTML5 dialog tag, web view.
You'll notice that focus doesn't go behind the modal, just like when I was using a desktop screen reader. However, this is not because of the focus events I described earlier. The problem with most, if not all, mobile screen readers is that they don't fire focus and blur events back to the browser when swiping over the document. In order to code this behavior on mobile, developers must set aria hidden equals true to all elements outside of the modal dialog. This may seem a little scary if there's a lot of interactive elements outside the dialog. I mean, who wants to set aria hidden attributes on all of those DOM nodes? However, there is an efficient algorithm to do this, and it's in the blog post that accompanies this video. If you are playing this video on the YouTube website, the link to the post is in the description below it. Hope this demonstration was helpful. Please feel free to comment on my YouTube page or my blog, useragentman.com. I'd love to hear your feedback. Thank you.